Hey everyone, I'm Vincent. Job searches can be really challenging, but there's two specific activities that can accelerate your success to landing your dream job. Back in high school, what I used to remember most from my summers was running, but not just once a day, usually twice a day. It was still dark outside when I'd jump out of bed, grab a bite of granola, and head out to meet the rest of the team. Now, morning workouts were typically longer runs, usually to the beach and back. We'd finish up before the world around us was even waking up. Later in the afternoon, though, we'd return for a second workout, where we'd usually be doing strides, which are shorter repetitions of sprints. Now, these workouts twice a day were exhausting, but they definitely paid off. These two distinctly different workouts help build speed and endurance. Now, job searches also consist of two distinct but very different activities, networking and preparation. So, today we kick off a new series at Viton. It's called Two-A-Days, getting an interview every day. This segment of our Viton series is all about how to get a job interview every day. Each video is going to cover a different strategy for maximizing your chances of having an interview every single day so that you can shorten your job search time and start that dream job as soon as possible. Searching for a job can be draining, especially if you're working hard, you're applying to hundreds of jobs a week, and maybe you're not getting as many responses or you're not getting as many phone calls back as you would hope. If this sounds like your job search, it's time to start working smart, not hard. Now, the first lesson about narrowing your job search is, you know, when you get desperate in a job search, a natural impulse could be to apply for every single job that you see. And applying for jobs, though, is not a numbers game because it's all about quality and fit over quantity. You really only need one job. Now, take two different candidates, for example. Sarah is looking for a job as an entry-level analyst. She's completed a lot of accounting courses, and she applies to 30 different roles across multiple industries and multiple company sizes. She's got a good resume, and her cover letter shows that she's a well-qualified candidate. Both of them are very well-written, and she uses the same resume for every single application. Candidate number two, though, Jamie takes a different approach. She's completed the same accounting courses, but in college, you know, she was also took a lot of science courses and she volunteered her time at a local clinic. She has a passion for helping other people. So instead of applying for every single analyst role in her region, she actually targets financial analyst roles because she had an internship as in a similar role last summer. But she targets healthcare companies because she enjoys her time at the clinic and she's interested in helping other people in the healthcare industry. Now, Jamie applies for less roles, but she's able to get a job sooner because she narrows her search to align with what her interests are, and she used her saved time from not applying to 100 jobs to be able to cater her resume and cover letter to each employer. Now, it might seem counterintuitive to apply for less roles, and it might seem that this would lower your odds. However, you're much more likely to get an interview if you tailor your resume and cover letter to the role. If you're applying to hundreds of jobs a month, then you're not truly customizing your resume for each role that you're applying for. You should try applying to less openings and spend more time working on each application. This is going to likely make you stand out among a group of really generic applications and shows that you're really interested in the role. So how exactly do you do this? Well, the first step is to make sure that you understand the job description for that role that you're going to be applying for. Now, imagine going on a first date and having a cheat sheet with the other person's interests, the other person's hobbies, and what they're looking for in a partner. You know, this is kind of what a job description is. It provides you all that information about the company and the position that you're applying for. It's going to highlight the traits, the experiences, the education that are desirable in a candidate. So you want to make sure that you look through the job description to match those up to your previous accomplishments and make sure that you highlight those similarities in your resume. So for example, in this job description that we're looking at over here for an events manager at Google, one of the responsibilities actually says managed local event budget. Now, this could be a great opportunity to include a line on your resume about how you were able to grow attendance at an event while lowering expenses at your last job. Now, if you don't have this experience in your last job, you can show it through skills in volunteer work or in other organizations. If you managed a budget as a social chair for your sorority, if you worked with a nonprofit, this could also be used to show your experience in managing budgets. Another way to ensure that your resume is a match is to summarize the themes or the keywords in the job description and match these to those in your resume or in your cover letter. Now, an easy way to do this is to use a word cloud, such as Worded Out. You can find this one or a similar tool on Google. Simply take a look at the job description and paste it into the text box. Then you can generate a word cloud with the most common words as the largest text size. In this visualization for the same job at Google, the most common words are local, community, marketing, advertising, and events. So the next step is to ensure that your cover letter and your resume actually focus on your previous experience and accomplishments in these same key areas using similar keywords. So in this lesson, we talked about strategies if you are currently applying to different job openings without finding much luck. If you're using the same resume, the same cover letter for all of your applications, it's time to stop. It's time to narrow your job search and really hone in on the jobs that fit your experience, your level, and your passion and interest. You're also going to want to customize your resume and cover letter to the job description of the organization that you're applying for. This is going to show that you're a great match for this opening that they're looking to fill. And don't be surprised if applying to less jobs, but spending more time on those applications actually gets you more interviews. Thanks for joining us today. Stay tuned for the next video where we're going to talk about how to find the perfect role to apply for. It's the next video in our Viton series, Two-A-Days. Get an interview every day. Now, if you liked this video, give it a big thumbs up and click on the subscribe button right over there on the Viton logo to see more videos.